Hi guys. This channel introduces the 5-axis CNC machine I made at home. So far, I have made 6 videos of how to build 5-axis CNC series. Maybe I'll make another video? This time I decided to start a new project. When I posted another video, some of the smartest people commented that it would be better to make a machine frame out of epoxy granite. I wasn't sure what it was at that time. I wondered if I would make a machine frame by processing natural granite. That's impossible at home. I Google it. Epoxy granite is a synthetic composite material composed of epoxy resin and granite chips, and seems to have been used since around 1970 as a high-performance alternative to steel and cast iron machine tools. The 5-axis CNC machine I made already has mechanical strength to machine steel materials. But not enough. 1. The noise during machining is noisy. 2. The lifetime of the end mill is short. The cause of these problems should be improved by increasing the strength of the machine. Industrial machine tools that is strong enough is very quiet when it have machining. With my own machining equipment, it is impossible to remake the base of a more powerful machine out of cast iron. Even with a small machine base of 400 mm square, it is impossible to purchase a cast iron material and accurately machining the machine base at home. This is the only equipment available. If I drink a lot of alcohol, and use the power of great alcohol, I may be able to cut it with my bare hands. But maybe my hands will be full of blood and completely unusable. So it's better to stop this idea. It turns out that epoxy granite is a very effective material. The gravel, sand and epoxies I need to make epoxy granite are cheap and easy to get. I basically don't need to use a big machine tool because I make formworks and pour epoxy granite into it. There is no problem even in a poor work environment like me. However, there are some disadvantages. With a metal base, I can make screw holes wherever I like when I want to install new parts later. For epoxy granite, it is necessary to embed nuts and tappable metal. I have to design firmly with 3D CAD. Also important is the blending ratio when making epoxy granite. According to my research, the important things are: make as much gravel as possible. Reduce the amount of epoxy as much as possible. It is to remove the air. This is my first test to make epoxy granite. I changed the composition on the way, so I didn't know the exact ratio. But I think it's pretty good. In fact, I made a basic mistake in this test. This epoxy had to mix the two liquids in a 3-to-1 ratio, but I mistakenly mixed them in a 2-to-1 ratio. Is it due to too much drank? The purpose of the second test is to accurately record the proportions of gravel and sand to epoxy. Using a water-soluble 3D printer material to hollow out the inside of the epoxy granite. First, I made this shape with a 3D printer. Embed this in epoxy granite, and when it hardens, dissolve it in water and it should open a hole. I think I am very smart. Yeah. In this test, the amount of epoxy was low and the amount of gravel was too much, so the air did not escape properly. The water-soluble 3D printer material didn't dissolve in water, as much as I expected. But I was able to remove it as soon as I picked it up with a drill. In the third test, we will try not to embed the nut in the epoxy granite and refer to the ratio checked on the net. According to the information on the website I referred to, sand 80%, epoxy 20%. But I don't like to obediently follow something, so I changed the composition a little. Yeah. As a result of three tests, it was found that all the test pieces had holes because the air was not completely removed. The ratio of epoxy granite is important, but I feel that how well the air is removed is important. From a strength standpoint and visually, I must create a beautiful base with no air holes. I want to make an artistic machine that makes me happy just by looking at it. I have to think about some measures. I need an effective vibrator. Finally, to test how strong these nuts embedded in the epoxy granite, I try tightening the screws until it breaks. I expected that tightening the nut would crack the epoxy granite. However, in reality, although it was deformed, it did not crack. In my opinion, epoxy granite seems to have both the hardness of the stone and the flexibility of the epoxy. There's been something great about this channel lately. There were two supporters who became members of this channel. I have other jobs, so the time I can spend on this channel is limited. Therefore, there is almost no benefit to those who participated in the membership. Still, there are two people who have become members. I thought about what I could do for them now. And the first thing that came to my mind was to express my gratitude honestly. From now, at the end of my video, I would like to introduce the members with the meaning of gratitude to the members.